Iraq war vet roughed up at McCarran Airport by Metro police officers. Tonight, Metro tells its side of the story.
And it's an exclusive conversation with Channel 13 Action News. We were first to show you these dramatic images captured at McCarran Airport. Well, tonight, Action News reporter Ben DC is standing by live with more on how the situation came to blows and how police are responding. Ben?
Yeah, those two Metro officers are still on the job, facing neither discipline nor charges as a result of what happened at the airport. In the meantime, Metro is asking the DA to pursue charges against the soldier involved in all this, Sergeant Mark England. It's grainy video that's been ingrained in the memories of so many. A melee at McCarran that had Metro officers toe-to-toe with an Army National Guard sergeant.
Ben, the way I look at this is if I'm back in Iraq and I do this to an insurgent, if I beat an insurgent like I was beaten, then I would already be in Leavenworth.
This entire series of events occurred as a result of the decisions that Mr. England consciously made.
In a letter to Sergeant England, Metro says it's closed the case and the department considers its officers blameless in the battle, saying their actions were, quote, justified, lawful, and proper, unquote. For the first time today, they talked to me about how they came to that decision.
Well, I'll tell you, the loud, raised voice, yelling, the almost constant profanities.
But it boils down to a single dollar bill. When Metro officers pull Sergeant England aside and ask to see a boarding pass, he goes into his pocket and comes up with the bill. The Metro officer tosses that bill on the ground.
Doesn't want to have anything in his hands. And again, asks for the boarding pass. That's when Mr. England became very angry and began to order the officer to pick up the dollar bill.
Metro officer saying, well, you were trying to be a jerk. Were you trying to be a jerk, Mark?
By me politely asking a police officer to pick up a dollar bill he threw on the floor as being a jerk, then I guess I was a jerk. I was never once confrontational with the officer or the TSA supervisor.
The beating that follows is brutal. By the time it's over, Sergeant England says he suffered broken ribs, a black eye, cuts and bruises all over his arms. You can see in the video, Sergeant England is trying to defend himself. He blocks the blows, balling up his fist in the process. And that's when the melee escalates yet again. You can see the second officer run into frame with a taser-like weapon at the ready.
Because he still is not complying.
Next, you can see Sergeant England collapse to the ground. Metro figures its officers shot England 5 times with the electronic charge, but the first 2 misfired.
I think being tasered 3 times was 2 times too many for anybody to get tasered. I think a national policy on tasering and then more oversight on use of force would be something positive to come out of all of this.
Metro says England is using the uniform as a soapbox.
That bothers us somewhat. I mean, we have 7 of our own officers within our department that are currently deployed to Iraq right now. We don't think that this is the type of behavior that an American soldier should be displaying.
An American soldier now involved in a legal war right here in his homeland. And that's really the shame in all this. In Sergeant Mark England, you have a guy who, by all accounts, is an outstanding soldier. But instead of fighting for us in Iraq, he's stuck here, injured and embroiled in controversy. I'm Ben DC, reporting live now, Channel 13 Action News.